Hello and welcome to round three of the FRS Dirt Rally Championship. Plenty of risks for the drivers again this week as we are jumping between the trees in Finland. Expect a lot of damaged cars crawling to the finish line by the end of these nine stages. And by the end of this one, we will be one third of the way through the championship. And that championship looks like this, with Rick C 137 leading the way with 240 points from the first two rounds. Fraser and Ettore narrowly behind. On we go then, and it's another pronunciation nightmare. Javenkila, I think is how you do that. 5 miles for the first stage, overcast conditions, but nothing worse than that. And it was Fraser who got off to the best start, 2.3 seconds quicker than anybody else in stage one in his Ford Fiesta as he looked to make up ground in the championship. Rixie 137 though was second quickest, no surprises there, as the Peugeot driver continued his fine form from the first two rounds. Elsewhere, Cookie also had a good run in the Volkswagen Polo, going P3 in the stage, 6.2 seconds behind. Disaster though for me, with a graphics card nightmare halfway through the first stage.
Turn five right of a junction, 60.
Oh no! I can't help but think this is bad. So your top three as previously advertised in stage one, with Ettore fourth and Dante fifth. Moving on to stage two, and it was gloomy conditions to say the least for Kotejavi. Again, this pronunciation is probably terrible. But good runs here from Ettore in the Citroën, going P2 with a time 5.7 seconds off the overall pace. A big mistake from Fraser on this stage meant that he lost over a minute to the leaders, and that very much scuppered his chances in this rally. Elsewhere, Dan had a good run to P3 in stage 2. The British driver proving that when he doesn't have Windows update issues, there is good pace in that Skoda. With Fraser out of contention, the door was open now for Rixie to lay down his authority on this rally, and he did exactly that in stage 2, 5.7 seconds clear of the field. And that gap up to 11.7 seconds from Ettore already after just two stages here in Finland. Kuki third. On to stage 3, and we move from dusk into full nighttime conditions here in Finland. And that's always going to be a challenge when you're jumping at high speed between the trees. One driver who came out all right was Booth, who moved himself up to fourth place overall in the Rally of Finland after this one, with a time good enough for P3 in the stage. Less fortunate was Pretend Soda, who was less than pleased with one of the pace notes from his co-driver, massively overshooting a call of 6 left into a rock and losing his headlights for the remainder of the stage. Not ideal. As you'd expect, serene progress for Rick C 137, who was having fun amongst the jumps. His Peugeot going quickest again in stage 3. Another strong stage for Dan saw him split the two American drivers into P2, Ettore 4th and Jabba 5th. Overall, Ettore still 2nd, with Dan now hot on his heels in 3rd place. Booth moving up into 4th and Dante remaining in 5th place, Cookie dropping backwards. The big news at the first service point was the retirement of Fraser from the rally, which would have huge implications for the championship. Very minimal points being picked up by the German. And a feel-good story from stage 4, with home hero Jabba picking up the quickest time of all. The Finnish driver topping the timesheets for the first time in any stage this season. Meanwhile, we're now on board with Garli, who was demonstrating the risks of the Finnish stages. Slightly miss here in the call, and big, big damage from the hit directly into that telephone post. Second place was Rixie 137, and this onboard footage from his YouTube channel showing precisely the level of commitment and speed required. The championship leader almost losing it on multiple occasions here, right on the edge of the limit of grip. Behind the top two, Dan was third quickest ahead of Booth, and a rare foreign at the top five for Jamstruth, who was fifth. A mistake for Ettore dropped him back to fifth place, losing about 30 seconds in that last stage. Dan now up to second with Jabber in third. Darkness was setting in again as we moved on to stage five. Yukizyavi? Vowels, guys, vowels, come on. Anyway, there was good pace from Cookie in this one, who finished P3 in the stage. The Season 1 champion is showing flashes of pace, but really struggling for the sort of consistency that's needed to challenge right up at the top of the rallies. But managing to keep out of trouble on this one. Jamstruth, fresh from his P5 in the previous stage, was, it's fair to say, living on the edge a bit all the way through this run, as this onboard footage shows.
And six right of a crest long, hit a six left, and sudden three right, opens six of a crest, 80. Flat left, keep right of a 50, three left tightens, and six right of a crest long, 50. Keep middle.
Another good run from Dan, who was very much lacking the outright pace of Rixie 137, about 5 seconds back in stage 5, but was doing a good job of establishing himself as the second quickest driver here in Finland. It's pretty much any five of the same six names that are making up the top five positions here in Finland. Rixie 137 from Dan and Cookie this time, Ettore 4th and Booth in 5th. Rixie's advantage at the top over half a minute now. Jabber made a mistake on stage 5 which dropped him back to 5th place. Stage 6 and time for the inevitable wet weather stage. Narayavi back the way we came the last time, and to be honest the rain didn't do a lot to upset the status quo. Treacherous conditions, really really slippery. And Timolele managed to get up into the top five on the stage. P5 for the German-Canadian driver, who was really giving it everything in the slippery conditions. In the midfield, Lightbock was going strongly, the Scottish driver in the Ford Fiesta, continuing without too much trouble, though quite a way off the overall pace, seventh in the stage, and a good 2 minutes 12 off the overall pace of the front runners. Speaking of front runners, Rixie 137 was fastest again, though not too much quicker than Dan and Ettore, the American driver extending his lead at the top of the Rally of Finland. Dan was valiantly trying to cling on to Rixie 137, but lost another 3.5 seconds as the Peugeot driver won stage 6. Booth was the driver to make a mistake this time and drop about 20 seconds. In the overall standing, Rick's lead now 35.5 seconds to Dan, and near enough a minute over Ettore and Jabber respectively. The map for stage 7 looks deceptively easy, but this was a stage that really started to test the drivers. Lots of problems for those, especially in the midfield here. Pretend Soda was running in 17th place at the end of stage 6. And nearly saw his rally come to an end entirely. Another misheard call note, and so close to being wiped out against the logs there, just about getting away with it and able to rejoin the course without too much damage to his car. He wasn't the only one. Garley here having an oversteer moment after one of the jumps and ending up taking some damage against the tree. Thankfully, the Frenchman was able to recover to the course and continue on his way. Now on board with Jamstruth, who had what can only be described as a moment to forget.
How? Come on. You're kidding me.
Attempting to fix one mistake and compounding it by making another, Jamstruth had to run the rest of the stage with no lights. On the recovery trail was Booth, who brought his Skoda back up into the top five in stage seven. A P3 finish for this one for the American, just 8.5 seconds off the outright pace. Continuing the theme, it was Dan's turn to make a mistake, and he lost around 20 seconds on this stage, like Bot, with a first ever finish in the stage top five. That mistake from Dan allowed Ettore to close to within a second in the fight for P2, both drivers now over a minute behind the leader. We had a beautiful sunset for stage 8, but the state of play was certainly more beautiful for some drivers than it was for others. Championship leader, rally leader, stage leader, pretty much everything leader, Rick C137, was quite literally flying.
To keep middle of a crest into five right tightens, three.
An impromptu wheelie from the American, who probably didn't need to be pushing this hard in stage 8 with such a big advantage, but realistically probably doesn't know how to go any slower. Ettore was pushing hard, trying to keep up, and was now up into P2. We'll ride on board with him.
Flat jump, 50. Flat left of a jump, 30. Five left of a jump, 150. Five right long of a crest, 100 of a bumps.
There were plenty of cars in the midfield that were clinging desperately to the hope of just making it to the finish line. Van on base managed to put together a time good enough for P7 in the Mitsubishi Space Star, but was almost 7 minutes off the overall lead now.
Right.
Meanwhile,
50. Five left, open six of a crest.
Oh, that one felt painful.
Flat right of a crest, 50.
It's broken, guys, I can't turn right.
Flat jump to jump, 50.
Oh my god, stop going left. This is full lock to the right. Come on!
Jump into six left.
Normal service was resumed in the top 10 with Rixi, Ettore, Booth, Dan, and Jabba, all covered by about 9.5 seconds. And there's now less than half a tenth of a second between Dan and Ettore going into the final stage, with Jabba and Booth a further 20 and 25 seconds further back. Stage 9 was the longest one of the whole rally, Kontinjärvi finishing the Rally of Finland for us at 9.35 miles. This one, of course, was the power stage, which meant that there was additional championship points available, 25 points to the stage winner, 15 points for second place, and an extra 10 points if you finish third. One man who would not be finishing in that top three was Hummersep, whose Volkswagen Polo had sadly given up the ghost.
I think my engine died. Okay, it's back up. Yeah, barely. Give me second gear. Come
30.
On.
30. Four right. Very long of a crest. Opens.
Yeah, second gear.
It was a similar story for Garley, who's had his most eventful rally to date. Another mistake here on stage 9 cost him a little bit more time, but he was able to get going again. With little to no chance of winning the rally, Ettore gave it everything he had to try and pip Dan to second place and pick up the extra points for the power stage victory. The Citroën driver right on the ragged edge, as always. But it wasn't to be the case, as Rick C137 won the final stage to pick up even more championship points, flat out once again over the jumps, and really, really close to it all going wrong here.
And keep right of a crest, jump 70, keep middle of a jump long, into six left of a dip, and crest 150, six right of a crest long, tightens of a jump 30, flat jump 100. Flat middle of a big jump, 150 of a bump.
In typical Rick fashion, though, it didn't go wrong, and by the end of the stage, he was fastest of anybody, 6.2 seconds clear of the Torre. Booth was third, with Force 12 fourth, and Jam's Truth fifth. Dan having a poor stage and slipping back into sixth place in this one. Confirmation then that Rick C 137 opens up the season with a hat-trick of victories, winning the Rally of Finland here. A Torre second and Booth third, picking up additional points as well for the power stage result. Dan will be a disappointed fourth in the end, with Jabba 5th, Lightbot 6th, False 12 7th, Jam's Truth 8th, Garly in 9th place, and Pretend Soda getting a top 10 finish. Only 6 of the drivers actually finished the rally. Van on Base, Dante, Moondingo, and Brad Spitt made up positions 11 to 14, while Hummersep somehow managed to finish behind me despite the fact that I got a full 15 minutes for stage 1. Clearly, plenty of damage on the Germans' Volkswagen. The first of the non-finishers, Timberlele, Hercules, Madster and Cookie. And the rest of the non-finishers, Black and Gold 56, Popsicle, AWD Turbo Guy, Sienna Bob, Penichiro and Voki. As always, you can catch up with everything FRS via all of the FRS social channels displayed for you on the screen now, as well as everything that I'm doing on my own Twitch channel and this YouTube channel as well. Though I'll admit, the Twitch channel is a bit more active. The next round is amongst the picturesque autumnal colours of New England in the USA. We will catch you there.